barbarous murder on the country roadside, all throughout Berkshire, is spread far and wide. An inspector of police and a private as well, both have been murdered, we're sorry to tell.
Those are the opening lines of a ballad written soon after two policemen were found dead in Berkshire. Murder ballads were a popular tradition, a mix of lurid detail and stern moral judgments. But what was the truth behind this particular text?
On a cold December night in 1876, Inspector Joseph Druitt and PC Thomas Shorter were on patrol at Folly Crossroads, just north of Hungerford.
They were looking for poachers up here, out in the countryside. Poaching was a prevalent thing. People were supplementing their meagre supplies of food.
When the policemen failed to return, a fellow officer went to look for them.
Upon Monday night, their bodies were found by another policeman on his lonely round. When near Denford Toll Bar, a sight met his gaze he'll never forget to the end of his days.
In fact, both bodies were found close to this crossroads.
They were. Poor PC Tom Shorter was found bludgeoned to death just round the corner there, and Joseph Druitt was found with terrible gunshot wounds to his face and neck just a little bit further up the road there.
Word spread quickly. The keeper of the toll gate just down the hill reported two men, William Day and William Tidbury, had passed through that night.
William Day was arrested at his cottage as he ate breakfast. By 9 o'clock that morning, William Tidbury was also under lock and key at Hungerford Police Station, along with his brothers, Henry and Francis.
The small community, the town of Hungerford, and the town was absolutely incensed and outraged by it. They were shocked.
Evidence against the four men included footprints from their boots and bloodstains on their clothes. And the muddy cap found at the scene was Henry Tidbury's.
All four men were sent to Reading for trial, where Henry and Francis confessed to the killings.
This book is a book of reports by the justices who visited Reading Jail every week and made notes about what they saw there. On the 24th of February, 1877, the justices visited the jail, and they've made a little note here, and it says, F.G. Tidbury, Francis Tidbury, made a full statement of his guilt before us. So he has confessed. He said, yes, I did it.
William Tidbury and William Day were acquitted, but there was just one punishment for Henry and Francis.
Blood for blood has long been the law of this land, and in crimes that are done with a cowardly hand, it is nothing but right such men should be taught the revenge of a murderer is too dearly bought.
Henry Tidbury and Francis G. Tidbury were hanged on Monday last at 8 a.m. and after the inquest, buried in the jail garden.
Back in Hungerford, a public subscription scheme raised a generous sum for the two policemen's families. Two memorial crosses now stand near Folly Crossroads, preserving the memory of Joseph Druitt and Thomas Shorter, who died serving their community.
In this particular case, we understand that the people who committed the murder had simply got two pheasant and one jay, and that was their total bag, and that's what the murders were committed for, in essence.
As they stand by the grave of those they love best, may their prayers be heard for the dear ones at rest.